that allow you to become the ultimate playmaker on the field.
Before I say goodbye, I'd like to say good day. And I hope you say goodbye when they ask, was it worth for you to pay? For my music, for press and play, for all the stress that went into my songs, my love and hate. The most honest I could be with you to date is to say thank you, Shady, for letting me be me with no holes barred. Thank you for the chance to enhance this old car, this old job. And there's but two fine lines on a blank sheet, but so far, these two lines point directly to my home on the mothership sonar. Valet UFOs, I go par. The Dirty South needs a soap bar in the mouth of these MCs, but who am I to judge getting broken co-stars? And I'm soaking so hard from the sweat that I could take my clothes off. And the whole yard should sit back and shake the dough off. But I'm already gone. I got a vision like telephones in an envelope like letters, lettuce, green, money, loan. Wolf packs in the cow's home. I keep making these sound bones. Yeah, you might have heard a dial tone, but I was on the other line when I hung up the phone. I send a postcard when I leave. I think about you when I dream. And when I'm up under the high beams, I reflect that shining. So you can feel the heat of light and life of fire, the sun of dying. Yeah, I done come a long way from Dixieland. Take my hand.
I'm talking low rider. 77 reviews, L Dogs, nothing but the man.
Hello everyone, I'm Larry Ridley and this is the NFL on EA Sports. In today's game, we have two quarterbacks who rank among the very best when it comes to pure arm strength. It's Aaron Rodgers going up against Jay Cutler. Now we'll take you out to Lambeau Field where Jim Nance and Phil Sims have the call.
It's the NFL on EA Sports, and we're getting set for an NFC North matchup as we join you from historic Lambeau Field.
Hello, friends. Jim Nance along with Bill Simpson. You just have to love these types of games because there's just so much bad blood. There's such a deep rivalry here. The spirit is intense, and these teams will do anything to beat the other team.
Well, they will, and we know that. It's just more attention to the details for the players during the week, and also you got to be ready for trick plays. The coaches, they want to try to fool the other team, give their team an edge, so you got to be ready for fake punts, fake kicks all during the game.
The Bears are ready to run back this kick. And Mason Crosby looks set now to kick it away. And with that kick, these two rivals are ready to go. And he'll start his return. And he's met head on right there at the 20. Cutler's heading out now for his first series.
Well, we've talked so many times about Jay Cutler's great talent. It's time to see it all come together. He has talent and experience, and it's time to get it done.
First down at the 20. Forte's taking the handoff.
The defense doesn't want to give up runs like that, so how do they stop it? Well, they start crowding the line of scrimmage, so you keep crowding that line of scrimmage. Look out, they'll throw it over the top.
Forte lines up as the single back here. The Bears will take the snap from the 25. As we take a look at the lineups, Alshon Jeffrey, one player we'll be watching today on the outside.
Absolutely, we're going to watch him. Why? He's a matchup nightmare. He's tall, got good hands. He is tough to cover.
Third down now. The Bears come out in a two tight end set. Knocked down.
that time, reading the quarterback and the receiver and being in position to knock that football away. That is really well played. That's a clinic. Put that on the highlight film and show guys how to do it.
Hines going to take this one from the 24. That return's good for about 14. Coming onto the field at quarterback, the man who took over the position for Brett Favre and has created his own legacy in Green Bay, quarterback Aaron Rodgers.
Well, when you talk about Aaron Rodgers, I think it's universally agreed. Everybody thinks he's the best quarterback in the NFL because there is no weakness to his game.
First down at the 38. Scans the field, and on the catch, it's Randall Cobb. As we take a look at the offense, Jordy Nelson seems to get better every year in this league.
Jordy Nelson has been a solid player for this Green Bay all the last few years. Fast, big, can really go up and get those catches when defensive backs are draped all over.
Lacey, a solo back set. Here's the handoff, and they'll run it. It's got some daylight. Gains 13.
Lacey is a great running back to have on your football team, isn't he? He goes up in there and gets the first down. Now your offense has three more chances.
First down and 10. Handoff. And he's going to be tackled right around the 43.
About him is Jimmy can play about four different positions on the field, outside, inside. He can do whatever you want on the defensive side.
Second and 6. And a flag comes out.
Offside defense.
The penalty is declined. That last play will hold up. The Packers take it from the 23. Lacey takes the hit and is brought down. Only picks up a couple.
Well, I know it was a short run that time by the offense, but it's what it's going to do for you long term. Keep running that football. Try to wear the defense down.
The Packers from the 22. Aaron Rodgers falls out. The defense has the football. He's brought down. The defense comes up with the big play, the hit, and the recovery of the football.
They sure did. They got so much speed on the defensive side, and that speed, when you think about it, it gets more people around the football. It helps you deliver the hit even harder, and that's why they got the turnover. Great job.
One of the best pass-rushing linebackers in football is Clay Matthews.
Love these type of players on your defense. The Green Bay defense, they need toughness, a relentless pass rusher, and that's what they got with Clay Matthews.
Cutler comes out in the pistol. Second and 10. And a flag comes out. The defense will take the penalty. After that penalty, it's now second down and 20. Forte's lined up as the single back. Looking across the middle, over the middle, and incomplete that time.
That time, the man-to-man coverage won. The quarterback had to make a perfect throw. He didn't. Incomplete pass.
The Bears go with two tight ends on this play.
Down the field.
The pass, ball's incomplete, and they fail to pick up a first down on this series. A defensive battle at the start of this game, waiting for one of the offenses to break through, Phil.
Yeah, and if you're on the offensive side, Jim, you don't press the issue. This is about managing the game, seeing what the defense is doing. Just keep plodding along, and sooner or later, you'll find a sequence of plays that work for you and give you a chance to get it going on the offensive side.
The Packers offense retaking the field, probably still feeling the sting of their last possession when they were in scoring position only to fumble the football away.
Look how hard it is to score in this league. And when you get a chance and you get down there, what do? You get four or five maybe scoring opportunities every single game. Then you just give one away with the fumble. That's a terrible job.
Second and short. And Rodgers will hand it off. And he's taken down, but not until he picks up the first.
What a good job by the running back that time. He reads the blocks very well, and he picks his way through there and picks up a first down. That's nice.
First and 10. Back to the ground. Taken down at the 39.
Lacy is never able to build up that power that he has as a running back when there's nowhere to go. Hey, there's nowhere to go. That's a short game.
Rodgers set, empty backfield. The Packers have it at the 39. And now Rodgers will give himself up.
It's not as easy as it looks. That quarterback, good job of sliding before he takes the hit that time.
The Packers get set at the line, needing to get to the 30 for a first. The Packers have it at the 34. They'll throw it over the middle. Two hands on the football and has the catch.
Offside. Defense.
They'll decline the penalty and let the play stand. First and 10. Here's the handoff. They knock him down behind the line of scrimmage.
Got to give the defense some credit on first down. There's so many things the offense can do. They were ready for that play and they stopped it.
Second and 12. Right back to him one more time. He's averaging about 4 yards a carry.
Well, the defense has got to be happy about this situation. Anytime early in the game you get an offense in third and long, you are looking to make a play and get things rolling on your side.
The Packers from the 27. Gets his feet down right near the chalk. About the way he always locks in and concentrates on the catch.
Man, he's got hands like glue. When you shake his hand, he can break yours because that's how strong they are. So not surprised to see him just reach out and just snatch the football out of the air.
First and goal from the 10. Has it. Touchdown. They've got a lead for themselves midway through the first thanks to that touchdown.
Yeah, it was a good drive that time. It had a little bit of everything in it, and it just gives you tremendous confidence as here we are halfway through the first quarter. Now you put the pressure on the other team.
The Bears are ready to return the kick. Thompson's got it on the return. The tackle is made right around the 25-yard line. The Bears weren't able to get anything out of their last drive and were forced to punt. As they take the field here, do you think they are going to vary their approach, Phil?
Well, I hope so. I think they will. They got a lot of information out there in that short drive, Jim, and you do that by showing different formations and plays. You saw how the defense reacted to it. Now you counter-react and see if you can get some positive plays.
I'm sure they're tired of being in the three-and-out business.
That's a bad business to be in. I know. I get in a lot of bad businesses.
Cutler's lined up. Two tight ends set. Launches it down the field. It's intercepted. Midway through the first quarter, and it's always a time when you're punching and counterpunching. And now they've got the pick and a chance to even score again.
Now, what would you know about punching and counterpunching, Jim? Were you a boxer at one time? It's amazing. You've done every sport. But you're right. They went out there. They did everything right. They've done everything right on both sides of the ball. They're looking good. Good job by the defense. They stopped the offense that time on first down. Now the defense is in a good situation.
The Packers from the 37. Looking long. Snatches it with one hand.
What must it be like to be able to go down there and make a play like that? How about it? One-handed catch, that was special.
Here's the first snap after the big play. Aaron Rodgers way down the field. This will be ruled incomplete. Didn't get the feet down.
Even the best quarterbacks in the NFL are not going to complete all these deep passes. The guy was open, but the quarterback misses it.
After the incomplete pass, it brings up second down. The Packers line up, split backfield. Looking at every option.
It's way too early in a game like this, in this situation, to take a chance. Run a draw, throw a screen, maybe just a straight-ahead run, but don't turn over the football.
Third down. Surveys. Aaron Rodgers out. Six on the board for the Packers.
Well, Jim, it's almost impossible to guard these guys nowadays as they go down the field. These wide receivers, they have feet like ballerinas. And even though you get tight coverage, they're so quick, they can get open and make the catches.
The Packers for the extra point. He made it. Rodgers certainly given his team some momentum with that scoring drive. He just put together a possession where he threw for more than 60 yards. The Packers getting set to kick it away. Thompson's got a chance to return this one. Taken down at about the 33, maybe the 34-yard line. The Packers' defense has been just remarkable. It reminds me of the Ravens' defense back in 2000 when they led statistically in virtually every category on their way to winning the Super Bowl, Phil.
Yeah, you talk about that defense. They were scary. My gosh, they went out there. If you scored a touchdown against that defense, Jim, you felt like you really had accomplished something. But so far here today, they've been dominant, and it's been fun to watch.
Second and 10 coming up. The Bears come out in the pistol. The Bears have it at the 34. Cutler is going to scramble.
This is a tough situation to be in. It's third long, and I'll say this to the coach and the quarterback. Don't take a chance. If it's covered down the field, throw it short.
Rodgers lined up in the backfield. The Bears have it at the 34. Got the catch. One-handed.
Jeffrey's got a pair of grippers, and of course by that I mean hands. They are big, they are strong, and you need those to make that one-handed catch.
Cutler is on the move. Bennett has the catch. That's his first reception today.
That's a good job by the quarterback. He read the defense. Nothing open deep, so he throws it short, and it puts him in great position for a second down play call.
They come to the line of scrimmage at the 29.
Forte lines up as the single back here. The handoff to Matt Forte.
If you're running back and you want more carries, do things like this. Read the defense right, read the blocking, and pick up first downs. That's a really good job by the running back.
The Bears have it at the 24. It's Bennett.
Hard to guard these tight ends now in the NFL. It really puts the defense in like a quandary. Do we use a big guy? Well, the big guy's not fast enough. We use a small guy? Well, he's not big enough. They get pushed around. I don't know what you're going to do. Just make sure you're a good tackler after they catch him.
Dan picks up about three.
Ortiz trying to be patient, but there is nowhere to run that time, and he only gets a short game.
Third and two coming up. Touchdown. That'll close the gap. Still a long way to go in this game, and they're able to keep it close with that touchdown.
Yeah, I know there's a long way to go, but here late in the first quarter, you're sitting here thinking, how are they going to turn this around? And it is amazing in the NFL. One play can change everything, and that's what just happened.
Driving extra point is good. The Packers kickoff return team is on the field. After seeing their defense surrender some points, the score's 14-7. The Packers are back deep, ready to return. Hyde's not going to test the coverage this time as he takes a knee. The Packers' offense came out and hit its stride in a hurry. And you got to wonder, Phil, when is this defense going to step up?
They are rolling. There's no doubt about it. Boy, it's fun to watch it. When an offense gets hot in the NFL, it's just fun for everybody, for the fans and even us as announcers, because you don't know what's going to happen next. My gosh, the wide receivers in the NFL now, it's incredible. It's not that you have one. Every team has two and three, and some have four. Good job that time by him hauling in that pass.
Looking to go deep. And he makes the catch. No, the ball comes out. The ball is knocked out of his hands.
Good job that time by the secondary. They're in good position. They make the play, and it's an incomplete pass by the quarterback.
The Packers will take the snap from the 30. Going deep.
I think it's important for the defense. Anytime it's a third and long situation for the offense, to know where those first down markers are, give a little ground, and make sure you're able to come up and make the tackle short of the first down marker.
The Packers come to the line. First down marker at the 40. Third and 10. Rodgers out to James Jones. Tackled by Antrell Roll.
When you play a cover three defense, you protect against the deep pass, but the problem is all the underneath stuff is wide open, and the quarterback is taking advantage of that.
First down at the 36. That's a gain of 8.
Always good to have these types of runs. Hey, it's not a first down, but it sends a message. It shows everybody that you can run it when you want to. And also, it opens up so many other things for your offense.
The Packers take it from the 28. And it's batted down. The pass play fails to work. And now it's third down. got it. And a first. That's another reception, giving him two.
Good route that time by the receiver on the out route. Nice throw by the quarterback. This is what they call a timing route. Well, they were right on time.
First and 10. They'll run it here. The Packers get a first down. The Packers still possess the football as we begin the second quarter. They're able to move the chains after that last run. And the second quarter is underway. They jam it in on the goal line. Touchdown. Their lead grows a little more with that touchdown. It's still a long way to go in this half. They may be able to add even more to it before the break.
Jim, I don't see anything that's going to slow them down. Everything they are trying is working. They have been spectacular here so far today. And all I can say to the opponents, you better buckle up. This is going to be tough.
Takes it from the four, and here we go. And he's tackled right at about the 28-yard line. The Bears offense coming back onto the field. It was a good drive for them the last time they had it, all the way down to the end zone for the touchdown.
Yeah, you know, in this game, Jim, it's all about momentum. And when you feel you've got the momentum on your side, you've got to take advantage of it. So now I think it's up to the offensive coordinator to call the right plays. That was a nice gain on that play that time. Well designed by the offensive coordinator. Yeah, it was a good throw and catch. But that time, I'm giving all the credit to the design of the play. That's what made it happen.
Cutler's now completed four in a row. It's a two tight end formation.
Now he's going to change the play. Look out. I think he's going to go down the field with the football.
Intercepted. Going to take it the distance. The 30, the 20, the 10, touchdown.